So good morning students, we were doing basic concepts of economics, revision module 3, okay. So we were doing this chapter and this is the third module of this chapter, revision module. Today we are going to discuss the concepts of price, general price level, inflation, deflation, okay. Price is the amount of money to be given to get a commodity. Okay, so suppose you went to buy a cell phone and that cell phone was around 10 or 12,000. So you pay that money and then you get the cell phone, right? So that cell phone has some features, certain value, okay? So for that value, you are paying 12,000. So the value of any commodity is measured by its price. And what is price? Price is the amount that you are giving to the shopkeeper or the producer to get that cell phone. Okay. Coming to general price level. General price level is the average level of prices of goods and services produced in the country. So, if suppose there are 1000 goods and services which are produced in the country, the average price will be all the prices of the goods divided by 1000. How do you calculate average and maximum? Remember, you write the prices of all the goods, 1000 goods and services, and divided by 1000. So general price level is measured to check whether the general price level has increased in the economy or it has decreased in the economy. Okay, so general price level is the average level of prices of goods and services produced in the country. Now, whenever we measure whether there is inflation or deflation, we take a base year. Okay, I'll explain to you the concept. Suppose there is a base year, the average price level, the general average price level of base year 2010, and there is current year 2020 price level. Okay, suppose I just take a normal example that in the base year 2010, the average price level was, I'm just taking an example over here, it was 200. Okay, and in the current year 2020, the average price level became 400. So there is an increase. There is an increase in the general price level. So whenever we compare with the base year and we find that there is an increase in the general price level, we term it as inflation. In the same manner, if I take the base year now here, 2010, and the current year again 2020, suppose the base year price, I'm taking an example over here, suppose the base year 2010 price was 200 and now in the current year the base year price, general price level or the average price level has become 150. Okay, so the base year price was 200 and now the average price level is 150. So there is a decrease in the general price level, and when we compare the base year and the current year and we find a decrease, 200 to 150, there is a decrease, we term it as deflation. So what is inflation? Inflation is the increase in the general price level and deflation is the decrease in the general price level. The next topic for today is inflation. Inflation is the process of persistent and appreciable rise in the general price level. Just now we discussed the meaning of inflation and deflation. So inflation is what? There are two keywords, persistent and appreciable rise in the general price level. So there are two conditions that are necessary for inflation. Two keywords are there, persistent and appreciable. Okay, the meaning of persistent is that the price rise should be continuous in nature, should be prolonged in nature. For a condition of price level to be a rise in price level to be called inflation, there must be continuous increase in the price level called a persistent increase in the price level, and there must be appreciable rise in the price level. The meaning of appreciable means that if a commodity price increased from 10 to rupees 12, it will not be called inflation. Okay, at least appreciable price level of 10 to 20% will be called inflation. Appreciable means the increase in price level should not be just of 1 or 2 rupees. It must be of something more amount. Okay, so there are three terms. Inflation is a process of rising prices and not a state of high prices. Okay, inflation is a process when there is continuous increase in price level. Continuous increase in price level, okay, and it is not a state of high prices. Due to seasonal problem, some vegetables get expensive. That is not inflation. Okay, so that is just a state of high prices. Sometimes tomatoes become really expensive, okay, in rainy seasons because of shortage of tomatoes. That is not inflation. It is a state of high prices. So inflation is a process of rising prices. Second point, inflation refers to a situation of appreciable rise in price. It means a price rise of 1 to 2 rupees is not inflation. It must be a huge increase to be called inflation. And the third point, rise in price should be prolonged. There must be continuous increase. There must be continuous increase in price level, and that price increase should be prolonged in nature. Okay. Like we compare the base year 2010 with the current year 2020. So that shows the prolonged and the continuous increase in price level. So now we move on to the next topic. The various type of inflation. There are two categories of inflation. Demand pull inflation and cost push inflation. What are the two categories? Demand pull inflation and cost push inflation. The inflation originating from demand forces are called the demand pull inflation, and the inflationary rise in prices due to increase in cost is called cost push inflation. So the inflation that is derived from the demand forces is called demand pull inflation, and the inflationary rise in price is happening due to increase in cost, then it is referred to as the cost push inflation. Okay, when does demand pull inflation happens? It happens when the demand of a commodity exceeds the supply of the commodity. Okay, when the demand for goods and services exceeds the supply of that particular good and service, then demand pull inflation occurs. When the demand is more and the availability of the commodity is less, the demand pulls up the price. Okay, so when the demand is more and the supply of that commodity or the availability of that commodity is less, the demand pulls up the price, and that is called demand pull inflation. You can see here, demand is more than the supply. When demand is more, supply or the availability is less, then demand pull inflation occurs. It is a situation of excess demand. Demand is greater than supply or availability. Okay. Coming to cost push inflation, I told you cost inflation occurs due to increase in cost. Okay, it occurs due to increase in cost of raw materials, wages, or the profit margin. Okay, so the cost push inflation happens when the raw material cost, the profit margin, the wages push the cost, and the cost pushes the price. What happens? The raw material, the wages, okay, the profit margin, they push up the cost, they push up the cost, and the cost further pushes the price of the commodity. To explain it, I have taken example of manufacturing of a shirt. Okay, I have taken a table wherein I have shown the manufacturing of a shirt. पहले raw material एक shirt को बनाने के लिए लग रहा था 500. Okay, तो raw material for making a shirt first was 500. The wages was 100. So the cost becomes 500 plus 100, 600. Raw material लग रहा था 500. Wages लग रहे थे 100. Cost हो गया 600. Now the person will sell it at a profit. So he was selling it at a price 800. Okay, what happens next? There is an increase in cost. Okay, there is the raw material and the wages cost is pushed. So raw material cost now has become 500. First it was 500, now it has become 700. So there is a 200 increase. Raw material cost has increased. Same way, wages was previously 100, now it has become 200. So 700 plus 200 gives you 900. पहले cost था 600, अब cost हो गया new 900. Okay, first the cost was 600, now it has become 900. There is an increase in cost, and again he will set it sell it at a profit. The manufacturer or the producer will sell the commodity at a profit. So he is selling it again at a profit of 200. The price of shirt was 800. Now it has become 1100. Okay, the price of the shirt. The price of the shirt was 800. Now it has become 1100. Why? It has become 1100 because the raw material cost was pushed up. Wages cost also increased. As a result, overall cost increased, and so the price of the commodity also increased. So the raw material and the wages pushed the cost, and the cost further pushed the price up. So this was about demand pull inflation and cost push inflation. Students, do watch the revision modules, okay, and do watch the previous modules also of this chapter where I have explained everything in more detail. Go through the video, students, please, okay, because this is all learning happening and we should take the opportunity to learn from the videos. Thank you. Stay safe, students.